Have you ever run into these challenges in Power BI? Especially when you're trying to make your reports automatic and not have to fix them every month or every year. Number one, you want a report that always shows a current period, maybe the current year, quarter, or month. Number two, maybe you always want to show a fixed rolling time frame, like the last 3 years, or 3 months, or 6 months. Or maybe you only want to show completed periods, like the current year up to today's date, so no future dates, or the current year up to the last completed month. So you're not showing partial months that can make reports look odd or misleading. Number four is for advanced users who may have run into the apples to oranges problem. When doing year-over-year comparisons, where you end up comparing the partial current year with the full prior year. Now, sure, you could do all of this manually by adjusting filters every month or writing complex stacks, but you don't have to. There's a much easier way, offsets. They're automatic, easy to use, and built right into the free Ultimate Calendar table that you can just copy and paste inside your Power BI model. Stick with me till the end, and I'll show you exactly how to use offsets to make your report smarter and self-updating. I'm Avi Singh, a Power BI Microsoft MVP, and through my online program on learnpowerbi.com, I have helped thousands of business users master Power BI and build beautiful reports. So here's what we're going to cover. First, I'll show you where you can get the easy copy and paste Ultimate Calendar table that includes offsets. Then we'll talk about the magical concept of calendar offsets, the real secret behind making your reports update automatically. We'll give you a demo showing how to use offsets to solve each of these problem scenarios we just talked about. And finally, stick around till the end for a bonus DAX tip that'll take this even further. Every Power BI model needs a calendar table, and you can create one in three different ways. You can use the built-in auto date time feature. You can create a calendar using DAX, or you can do it in Power Query. And I actually have a video that shows you all three approaches. Link is in the description. But the industry best practice is to use a calendar table created in Power Query. And the good news, you don't have to create it from scratch. Just go to learnpowerbi.com/calendar and grab my easy to use copy and paste Ultimate Calendar table. You'll get the download and a short instruction video that walks you through step by step on how to drop it right into your model. And once you do that, you'll unlock all the benefits of having a proper calendar table, especially the time intelligence functions and the powerful offsets feature we're about to dive into next. Once you follow the instructions on the calendar download page, you would be able to simply copy and paste the calendar table into your Power Query and load it into your model. Once loaded, you would be able to see all the columns that come built into the Ultimate Calendar table that always update automatically, and go into the relationship view and connect it to your data table. The instruction video on the calendar download page will help you get started with all of this. Inside your calendar table, you would right away see the offset columns. But let me first explain, what do we mean by offsets and how they work exactly? Let's start with the current month offset. So again, since the whole table, Ultimate Calendar table, is built in Power Query, it's automatically in there, automatically updates, and this is how it gets defined. The zero number is a numeric column, and the zero number indicates always the current month. And again, it updates automatically. So zero is the current month, and as you go to future months, plus one, plus two, plus three, these indicate the future months. And if you go back in time to the prior month, the one before that, they would go in minus one, minus two, minus three, and minus four, and so on. Now, of course, you can see how flexible this system is, and that's what makes it amazing. So for one, you can apply it to all the other dimensions. You can, we actually have the year offsets built into the Ultimate Calendar as well. With the same logic, zero is the current year, plus one is the future year next year, minus one is the prior year, and so forth. and we have quarter offsets, and actually we have week offsets and day offsets, and you can even create your own based on the kind of calendar you're using or the time periods you're interested in. For example, if you have a fiscal year, you could even use a fiscal year offset. It also has another shortcut that we'll be using, which is the future date field, which kind of draws a line through the calendar table with the value indicating future dates versus past dates, making it super easy to filter on this when you need it. Now that you understand how offsets are built and how they work, let's go ahead and attempt to solve each of the scenarios we talked about at the beginning. Let's revisit those scenarios. So in the first scenario, we want to show a fixed current period. And right now, I'm not using offsets, and that might mean I'm hard coding things like this. And this is what we want to avoid. We want to use offsets so this updates automatically instead of us having to change it, right? So this could be the current period for current year or current month or something else. The other scenario, the number two scenario, was a fixed rolling time period, which is we always want to show the past three completed months. And again, we do not want to hard code it. We do not want to come back and change it every month. The next scenario is when we want to show completed periods. For example, the current year, but only to the last completed month. And again, without having to hard code it into our filters. The next scenario, the number four, is a little bit advanced, but if you've been using Power BI Time Intelligence, you may have run into it, and I call it the apples to oranges problem. If you look at this report, it's comparing partner sales for the current year versus prior year. And right now, it looks like that we are not doing well this year at all. But that is because we're comparing apples and oranges. If you notice the sales for the current year and the prior year, what you're gonna notice here is that the current year sales only go on till today. Obviously, well, at least in this data set, we do not have any future sales. I mean, sometimes you can record future sales, but here it stops at today's date, but the prior year metric has the full year's data. So again, that's why the apples to oranges problem. If you fix this, then we're gonna realize that actually we're doing really good year over year and actually have a small increase. So we're gonna solve all of these scenarios one by one using the magical offsets. All right, let's start with scenario one. And by the way, you can go to learnpowerbi.com/download to not only get this file, but the whole treasure chest of my Power BI files with all my tutorials. So if once you have this file, you can also examine in detail kind of the year offset, quarter offset, month offset, and so forth, how it's gonna work. But of course, make sure you first get the ultimate calendar table. So let's come back to scenario one. So again, what we're gonna do is we're gonna remove this hard coding. So right now it's 2025, and we're gonna have to come back and change it every year. I always say that a great sign of a good Power BI developer is somebody who's lazy. And I mean that in a nice way, is that, yeah, we don't wanna come in, we wanna automate as much as possible. We don't wanna come in and make manual changes. So I'm gonna delete that. And then again, we have these incredible offsets. So we're gonna use that. In this case, we're gonna use the current year offset, where zero would always indicate the current year. So I'm gonna go here and go to my calendar table and current year offset, drag that over here. I can stick with advanced filtering in this case, and I'm gonna click is zero, which is the current year, and click apply filters. And of course, you can see in the month year slicer here that it's displaying the current year. It's also seen in the label here, showing you the dates. And of course, if you really wanna check every single detail, you can see the date field, and it goes on from January all the way to the end of the current year. But again, the big difference is that this is gonna update automatically and always show the current year. So you don't have to update it manually. All right, so let's go. And again, the similar way, you can use the current month offset if you wanna see the current month or current quarter or something else. Let's move on to the scenario two, where we always want to show a rolling period, always want to show the past three completed months. And again, we want this to update automatically, not have this setup where we're like, oh yeah, we come in and change this every month. That's kind of silly. We're better than that. So I'm going to delete that, remove this filter. And in this case, I'm going to bring in the current month offset. And again, if you examine the current month offset, then Let's go here. Yeah, so zero is the current month. If you're looking for completed months, we want to go from -1, -2 to -3. And we go in here, so we're gonna say is less than or equal to -1, right? And it's greater than or equal to -3. And just hit apply. And again, we have the slicers to easily, so you can detect that what it is doing right now. So right now it's November 10th. So it's selecting August, September, October as a 3 completed months. But again, the beauty of this is that it's gonna update automatically. So once you go on to December, then it's gonna switch to September, October, November as the completed months. You don't have to come in and change this at all. So that's the rolling period. So in this scenario, we wanna show the current year, but we only want to show, all the completed months, right? So we don't want to select -1, -2. We want to say, hey, in the current year, show me all the months that I've completed. And by the way, if you don't do this, then depending on the data set you're reporting, it can be partial data. It can look really wonky. So in this case, we're at November 10th. So yeah, the sales haven't quite come in for November. So it, and you know, the graph takes this nosedive. If you're seeing things like this, and sometimes you want to show that, but sometimes you do not want to show that because again, it's kind of misleading. It makes it look like November is, we're having a really bad month when it's just that we don't have, we only have 10 days worth of data. So for that, so again, right now it's hard-coded. We don't like that. We're the awesome, lazy Power BI professionals, Power BI pros. So we're gonna delete this one as well, and make it completely automatic. So we're gonna start with a current year offset, and we're gonna say advanced filtering is zero. This is gonna select the current year, but it's still showing us all the months. So it is showing us January through December. We don't want that. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna bring in the current month offset, add that here. And in this case, so unlike the rolling period where we selected -1 to -3, here we're simply gonna say is, current month offset is less than zero. Remember, zero is the always gonna be the current month, but that's gonna be the partial month. So we do not wanna show that. So we wanna show only completed months. So current month offset is less than zero. I apply that and bada bing, bada boom. October is the last completed month. So that looks good. Everything looks good here. Now let's step into our slightly advanced scenario, the apples to oranges one. So again, the challenge here is that while the current, by the way, just FYI, this is a slightly different data than what we've been looking at so far, sales versus budget. This is partner sales. This is a different table, but I'm just using a different table to illustrate this concept that, you know, if you're looking at partial year, this only has data, as we saw earlier, this only has the actual data till today's date. So today is November 10th. It only has that. It does not have future date, but the prior year is being compared to the full year. And it's kind of messed up anyway, the year is hard coded. So we're going to take a copy of this, and we're gonna fix it using our awesome offsets. So first we're gonna go and we're gonna apply the current year offset is zero. All right, so now earlier we were doing completed months, but now we wanna show year to date. We wanna show if we have data till November 10th, today's date, that's what we wanna show. Now you actually can do it using the current day offset as well, but we have a field future date, which indicates future or past, and that's just gonna be a lot more effective, a lot more faster, because it has fewer values in there, right? It just has two values, past and future. So let's get back to where we're trying to fix it. And in here, let's drag in the future date as a filter. And here you can see it just has two values, future and past. So we're just gonna select past so that the future dates are excluded. So now you can see that we're comparing apples to apples, and we can see that we actually had a non-moderate growth year over year, unlike the apples to oranges scenario, which was showing a steep decline. And of course, you can see by date that now both the current year and the prior year are being limited to a fair comparison. Now, there's a lot more that is possible with offsets, so it depends on your requirements and your creativity. But I had promised a bonus tip, so let's look at that. Now, we have so far seen a lot of scenarios where we have used the offsets in the filtering pane to automatically show a specific time period and so forth, right? But besides this, you can also use these in your DAX measure, and that's what's incredible about offsets. So sometimes you need a little more specificity. So for example, in one table, you might want to show kind of the sales, but sales for the past 3 months, past 6 months, prior year, all of that, right? And how are you going to do that with filters? It's just not possible. Even if you're applying a filter to the visual, you cannot have filters for separate columns. That is when DAX measures are incredible, because they give you the ultimate control, and now we're combined with the power of offset. So you can go in your measure and you can use the year offset to get the current year. You can use the current month offset to get the current month, or a fixed rolling period, or any other combination that we saw being applied in the filter pane can also be applied in DAX. So go to learnpowerbi.com/calendar and download the ultimate calendar table with the magical offsets and a whole bunch of other functionality for all of your Power BI time intelligence needs. If you have a Power BI question, message me on LinkedIn or send me an email at avi@avisingh.com. I'll see you in the next one. Take care and power on. This is from a family road trip. The kids were just goofing off at the sunset, and just watching them be so carefree kind of reminded me that we all have that child inside us, and you got to keep that alive, that spirit of freedom and joy.